they start the very first day. They make a decision, this is great, or I'm out of here. I mean, it's that quick. They are that quick to judge. So we need to keep people engaged. We need to get out of our own way. Stop thinking, well, why aren't they communicating the way we do? Why are they not being empowered by things that empower us? Why are they so different? Why are they so odd? How is this that they communicate? It is so different than how we communicate. It is so much often faster than how we communicate. I don't understand them. Well, let's take the time to figure each other out, understand ourselves better, understand each other better, show respect to one another, honor our differences, and therefore enhance our own and each other's success, right? Sounds pretty simple. It's really not, but we're gonna talk about that and hopefully come up with some solutions. A lot of people get grumpy, and so you're gonna hear me say a lot. You're gonna hear me say millennials, baby boomers, men, women. I am today going to put people into buckets. Sorry, but for sake of this conversation today, it's kind of something that I need to do. I know we are all individuals, right? We all have different drivers. We all really do care about different things. Doesn't matter when we're born. However, we do have generalized characteristics because of how we were raised, because of what we learned as we were growing up, what we experienced as we were growing up. So I know we're all individuals, but for the sake of this conversation today, as I state millennials, gender specific characteristics, be patient with me. I certainly am not meaning to upset or be politically correct in any way. Another reason why we need to really, really be careful and make sure that we are understanding this disconnect in communication between each other is there is as many as four different generations working together in one place. Grandparents might be working with grandchildren, probably not literally, but age-wise, right? And oh my gosh, there's such a disparity in how 60-year-olds talk and how 30-year-olds talk, what drives them, what connects them, how they process challenge. There's so many differences that we need to take the time to learn. Some older generations get grumpy that we're spending so much time on figuring out how to keep those born after the year of 1980 happy, engaged. Some of us think that they're kind of a pain in the butt. They're kind of thought to be entitled. Sometimes they don't know how to communicate. They are just out there saying, okay, this is what I want. This is what I deserve. This is what I need. And yeah, is that challenging? Is it different? Of course. But flip it. Paradigm shift. Bravo. They're asking for what they want. I'm a Gen Xer. I didn't do that. Nobody taught me how to do that. I wished I had. So rather than being grumpy with them for stating what they want, for asking for mentors, for being really open and vocal and verbal about how they're feeling, embrace it. Let's figure out how to honor it. And let's gain an opportunity to further the communication and better learn how to enhance each other's strengths, work together. The reason also why millennials are so important. By 2030, so 10 years, there's going to be approximately 80 million people born between the years of 1980 and 2000. 80 million people. That equates to, by 2030, 75% of the workforce is going to be millennials. Those born between the years of 1980 and 2000. 75% of the workforce, 75% of consumers. So we need to change our communication to empower them, to engage them, to get them to buy our products, to buy our services. We also must educate them to better communicate with us. We talk a lot about engaging them. We need to embrace them and empower them to better communicate and engage with us, because that is how they will be successful. If we focus on helping each of us become more successful, this will mean more trust, stronger relationships, more openness, stronger teams. It's a win-win to everybody, to the ROI, better workforce. We will be happier if everyone is working together, we're communicating better, we're learning to trust one another. So at this point, I'm going to ask you.